Let's record some MIDI now. First, let's make a track and call it drums. Let's get some drum sounds. Go to the VST Instruments under the Devices menu, and in the first open slot, choose LM7 from the Drums menu. This loads up the LM7. We won't need to see this, so let's get rid of it. And for appearance sake, let's just fold up these folders. Let's set the output of this track so it goes to the LM7. And then let's set its input. This input will definitely be different on your computer. Pick the MIDI in that your keyboard is connected to. Press the Record Enable button so we can hear our MIDI as we play on the keyboard, and so it will record on the track. I'm going to play something right now. We learned how to loop and snap in the previous videos. We also mentioned automatic quantize in the video on transport. I'm going to talk about them now. Let's get a loop going from bars 1 to 5 and then start recording. I'm going to turn snap on so that my right locator locks to bar 5. You'll definitely want to have the click on while you're recording, and you'll want to have a 2-bar count in just before you start recording, so you can start on time. That's what the pre-count button is for. To set your click preferences, go to Transport and choose Metronome Setup. For our 2-bar count in, we can set the pre-count bars right here. And we can set our level right here. Let's press the record button and start recording some drums. Let's take off the click and stop recording. As you can hear, my timing's just a little bit off. I'm going to erase this, turn on the automatic quantize, and re-record this drum beat. The quantize grid, which is discussed in the video on Snap, is set to 16th notes. This is a perfect setting for most MIDI that you'll record. With our automatic quantize button on, things should lock in time and sound great. Now that was much better. The automatic quantize locked it completely on time for us. Now if you're still a little unsure, let's make this super obvious. What I'm going to do is erase this and record some hi-hats for you now. I'm going to play the hi-hats as fast as I can, but since the automatic quantize is locked to 16th notes, Cubase will play it back only on the 16th note beat. Let's hit the rewind button and then press record. That sounds a lot better, nice and tight. Let's finish this off with a little bit of kick and snare.